Hello everyone, after a long time, welcome to 9design 3D. In this video, we will make basic hand grenade. Now, in the blender, let's start the tutorial. First, we will delete our holy cube with the X. And after that, with the pressing Shift A and image reference, you can choose some type of bronze view of the hand grenade and add into your blender. After you set it up, you can decrease your opacity like this. From the scene collection, you can choose selectable and after that, uncheck it. And now, we can't make anything to our reference. Now, with the Shift A, add a circle and set your vertices 8. Scale a bit. Z to wireframe, in tab to edit mode, choose your old vertices and E to extrude them up. After you give a shape, you can give a little ball shape like this with the moving your vertices and scale them. And now, in solid view, select all of your faces with A and after that press F3. Search as an extrude individual faces. After you select it, it will affect automatically. From the top, set your individual origins like this and as to scale all the pieces individually scaling. And what we will do for the bottom part, choose this vertex line with Alt, E to extrude right click as to scale, and again E to extrude right click as to scale. Choose these two edges and F to fill, choose side face and F to fill once, make same thing for the other side too. For the top, in Z to wireframe, choose this top all vertices and press X, delete these faces. And now, we can move all of our vertices with the same shape to the top. And don't forget to set your SZ0 and after that, E to extrude them up again and scale a bit. And E to extrude right click and as to scale. Right-click, loop tool, circle. We will give a circular shape now for the top of the grenade. Choose this vertex line with Alt and press G twice for the slide them. We got this type of shape. You can add some bevel and increase your segments. It will give our basic hand grenade shape like this. If you want, you can move some of your edge lines with the scaling or G twice for the sliding. Which shape you want, you can make it. For the top, I will press F and right click face mode and poke faces. For the top part, we will add a cube to our scene. Again, we will use our Z to wireframe mode for moving our vertices clearly. G to move some of the faces. In here, add extra loop cut with Ctrl R, middle of it. You can add extra loop cut with Ctrl R again. For the middle of the cube, add loop cut again and Z to wireframe. Choose side of the vertices and X to delete and add a mirror modifier in your object mode. Don't forget to check your clipping. And now, we will make some changes on it and it will affect to the other side too because of mirror modifier. You can choose some of the vertices and with the pressing G, Y, you can move them. I will choose this front face and E to extrude it and scale. For the sides, not suitable for me and I am moving my some of the vertices. Choose this bottom edge line and press G twice again for the slide them. We will get this type of shape. If you work with a different reference image, you can follow this type of method for top of the grenade. I am giving a shape for myself. And now I will add a cylinder for the front part of the top. Rotate an x-axis in 19 degrees. And scale how you want. Right-click Shade Smooth. And don't forget to check your auto smooth under the normals. or the tidying up some vertices. I am giving this type of shape. And now, I will add some loop cut again with the Ctrl R, choose this face line, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. For the choose all the face lines, you can use Alt. And I am adding a subdivision surface modifier. With the adding extra loop cut, you can give some sharp edges, but not sharpie. It will be getting a bit smooth. You can bring a shape which you want. I got this type of basic shape. All the granites are different from each other. You can make for yourself. Maybe you can change it as a sci-fi or the other type of the art. For the side, I am choosing my faces, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale, for giving some hole shape like this, and adding extra loop cuts. After all done, I will add a plane for the top shape. In tap to edit mode, I am adding extra loop cut again, as the same method, deleting half of it and adding mirror modifier in axis Y. And don't forget to check clipping. I am either extruding front part of the top and I am adding extra loop cuts. But as my reference image, I have to delete these faces from here. With the pressing X and delete these faces. You can see from the left part for my screencast, if I forgot to say something, you can look at them. For the back part, I am continuing to E to extrude for the holder type. You can hide other parts with the H. For the choosing only sides, you can E to extrude these vertices together. And I will E to extrude some part of it again and moving my vertices. For these two vertex, press M and merge them at center. Now, we can move them together. For the back part of it, don't forget to choose only side faces. We don't want to extra faces onto it, because maybe we can use this in the games. As the same method, merge them at center, some of the vertices between them, if they are too closer, and we don't have any extra geometry in there. I am adding extra loop cuts for merging my side vertices like this. And tied up your vertices how you want. I am extruding extra my only one vertex from the top. And we have to fill inner of it. You can follow my movements with the continued extruding of the vertex. And choosing four vertices and pressing F to fill them. If you don't have enough vertex between an edge line, you can choose this edge line, right click and subdivide. It will give extra geometry in there as a vertex. The top is ready, we can add some solidify modifier and increase your thickness. Right click shade smooth and don't forget to check your auto smooth. For the circular parts, I will add a circle with the 16 vertices. Scale and place side of the top part. And after that, in tap to edit mode, choose all of them with E to extrude in x-axis. Again, choose all of them with A and E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. It will give this type of ring shape for us. For the big part of the circle, you can follow same method. Select all, E to extrude in here and press Z twice and it will lock the axis like this. Select all of them again, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. For the side edge lines, you can choose them with Alt, Ctrl B to bevel them for giving some smoothness of our ring. For the back part, if you want, you can make some changes on it. Our grenade is ready. Now I am setting up my background for the render. You can add extra area lights. With increasing your power, you can add extra plane for the background of the grenades because we want to see our materials clearly. After I set up my background, I will add a material for myself. Go to Shading tab and press New. And now, you can give some name for your material. I will add some noise texture, color ramp, connect between them together, and add a bump node. Slide your color ramp nodes and make your darker value a bit lighter. Connect your color ramp's colored bump node's height and connect your bump to the normal. It will affect like this with the changing your strength and setting up your noise. Textures detail 12, you can give this type of shape. Now we will see clearly with our base color. Our grenade will look like this. For top of the parts, I will use same material. Don't forget to press this new material button. After that, you can give some new name for yourself and change your color. It will not affect of your main grenade's material. Which color you want? You can set it up. Which color you want, you can set it up. For the top of it, I am adding different colors. I want to make it a blue one, and I am pressing new material. For the back part of the blue, I will add with the plus icon, adding new material in here. I will use this grenade top and press new material. You can choose these faces and assign your second material like this for the one object. Our grenades will look like this totally, but I want to give some holes into it. So I'm applying my materials and shift it to duplicate cylinder. Scale a bit, place it. Don't forget to check your Ctrl A All Transform Set Origin to Geometry with right click. And now I will add some boolean. Choose your cylinder object as an object. Apply your boolean modifier and delete your cylinder. It will give a hole to us like this. And our basic hand grenades will look like that. If you want, you can get some render in the cycle or EV. That's your type, how you want. Feel free yourself. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new Blender tutorials.